Hello students, welcome to the topic theoretical distribution. And under theoretical distribution, today we'll be dealing with standard normal distribution. It is presented by Shantala Kulkarni, Department of Statistics, Goktipu College of Commerce and Science, Belgavi. So in the previous class, we dealt with the normal distribution, the definition part, then the features. The features are really important of the normal distribution. And normal distribution is dealing with continuous variable, continuous random variable. So we are not using the word as probability mass function. We are using the word as probability density function. And if you remember, the probability density function is very complicated, you know. Fz is equal to 1 upon 2 root pi e to the power of 1 upon 2 x minus mu divided by sigma the whole square. Now, if we have to solve the example, using this probability density function, very, very tedious, and you cannot solve the example. So hence, what we are doing, we are using standard normal distribution. And what is the standard normal distribution? If z or z is a normal variate with mean mu is equal to 0 and standard deviation sigma is equal to 1. Mu has to be 0, then sigma has to be 1. Then z is called a standard normal variate, and the distribution of z or z is called a standard normal distribution. The probability density function of standard normal distribution is fz is equal to 1 upon root 2 pi e to the power of minus z square divided by 2, where z is having the same range, minus infinity to plus infinity. Now what are these simple properties? For a standard normal distribution, mean is 0, variance is 1, standard deviation also is 1. The standard normal curve is bell shaped. Everything is same. The only change what we are going to make is you are going to take mu is equal to 0 and sigma is equal to 1. When you make this, and if you put these values in the probability density function of the normal distribution, you get this particular distribution. If you substitute the value of mu is equal to 0 and sigma is equal to 1, you get this probability density function. Yes. So the next point, the standard normal curve is symmetrical about z is equal to 0, that is mean is equal to median is equal to mode is equal to 0. The fourth one, total area under the standard normal curve is equal to 1. And the fifth point, standard normal curve is asymptotic to the x-axis, means the x-axis will never, the tails of the normal curve will never ever touch the x-axis. They will always be parallel to each other, so because, and they will be touching at minus infinity and plus infinity. Now, if we have to solve the examples, you have to use the normal distribution table, the value of z, how the probability value, because it is a continuous variable, you do not have a fixed value as to equal to, like for example, if you all remember, binomial, Bernoulli, Poisson or hypogeometric, you had a specific x value and then you had the specific n value also. But here it's not like that. The range is too vast. They may say find the probability of the students who have scored more than 40%. More than 40%, it can be any number. It can be 5 number, it can be 10, it can be 20. The number is countless. That's the reason the approach of solving normal distribution is totally different. Now the next part here, you are going to see if x is a normal variate with mean mu and standard deviation sigma. This is the important thing what you know we are going to use here. Z is equal to x minus mu divided by, this is the formula you will be using to solve the normal distribution examples. We have changed it, x minus mu divided by sigma. Mu value will be given in the question, sigma value will be given to you all in the question, and for x they will be giving in the form of more than, less than or in between. That you have to find out and solve the example. So this is the normal curve, how it is, how the shading part and all is done. For every example you have to draw this normal curve. If they say if it is more than, you have to do the shading, and then if it is less than, you have to do the shading with the towards the left hand side. And for every example you are going to mark this normal curve like this. the central part is going to be 0, 1, 2, 3 plus infinity, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and then minus infinity. This is how the marking. It's simple. I will explain it to you all, so don't panic about it. So the next part here is this table what you're going to follow. And these tables are available behind the textbook. Please take a Xerox copy of this, of all the statistical constant for Poisson distribution, for one, just take the Xerox of that and keep it with the even the binomial coefficients. You'll be using these values and then solving the examples. Now please pay attention to this chart. You have Z here and see the different values. The same thing is for positive. Here are the negative values and the positive values, and 0, 1, 2 till up, it is up to 9. You all just see this table, how we will use, I will explain it to you all. So this table here I have divided into two sets, all the negative values in two pages, and here the positive values, all the positive values are seen. Area under the normal curve from Z to infinity, all these values are given, 0 to 9 here also. Now we will take one example and solve. Now what is this first example? If x is a normal variate with mean 64, that means mu is equal to 64, variance 144, means sigma square is equal to 144, sigma will be equal to 12. Find the probability that, if you pay attention children, see how they have asked this. They have asked, first one, x is more than or equal to 67. All the examples will be of this format, more than or equal to. Then second one, it is lying between 60 and 66. You have to find out the probability value. Then the third one is x less than 62. So when less than 62 means it can be 61, it can be 61.99, anything. The range is too large. I hope you people are getting the concept. So when the range is too huge, it is continuous in the form, that's the reason the approach to solve normal examples is completely different that compared to binomial, Bernoulli, Poisson or hypergeometric, because they are all discrete. You have specific values. Here it's not specific, it will go on in a continuous floating way. So that's why we are going to use z is equal to x minus 64 divided by 12, or z is equal to x minus mu divided by sigma. This is the formula we'll be using. Now see, so first step is to write the given things. What are the given things? N, 64 is mu, and this is 12 square, that is nothing but variance or sigma. You have to write the formula z is equal to x minus mu divided by sigma. See, x is as it is, mu value is 64, we want sigma here, so square, the square root of that will be 12, which follows normal distribution, standard normal distribution, mu is equal to 0 and sigma is equal to 1. The next step what you are going to do is the first probability. What they have asked, the first probability, see, the first probability, x is more than or equal to 67. This is the first one they have asked. The same thing we are going to write here. The first point, here, px is more than or equal to 67. How do we write this? Please pay attention here. This first part will be writing whatever this is here. Same thing we are going to write. And this more than sign is here, same to same. And here this 67, wherever there is x. Now here x is there, na? What is the value of x here? 67. Mu 64. Sigma 12. So this whole term will become z here. This term will become z. More than equal to, calculate this, 67 minus 64 is 3/12. 3/12 is nothing but 0.25. So this is 0.25, this calculation we have done. Now this calculated part, you are going to draw the normal curve and locate. See, what is this normal curve? If you all pay attention, we have drawn the normal curve. Now central here it is 0. This value is positive, correct? This value is positive. So you are going to make the marking in the positive side. Approximately 1 is here. They have not shown. So it is approximate value 0. After 0, 0.25 you are going to make the marking here. Clear? What is the sign here? More than. More than means this side. If it was less than, you would have done the shading this side. If it is less than, you will be doing it in the opposite direction. More than towards your right hand side. This side shading you are going to do. Correct? Yes. Then next step is area from. Area from, you are going to calculate area from 0.25 to infinity. See, 0.25 to infinity. This value is available in the table. This is 0.25. You will come to the normal distribution page. Now see, remember, you are going to see this value Z 0.25. Wait. 0.25. Where are you? Yes. 0.2, fifth column. Here is the value. Correct? So this is how you see the table value of the normal distribution. 0.2 is here, fifth value. This is 0.4013. So that is the value we have written here. Got it? Next probability distribution is, its x is lying between 60 and 66. So the step is similar. First you will write this value 60, then minus 64 upon 12, less than or equal to x value, standard normal variate you want to write, x minus 64 divided by 12, less than 66 minus 64 divided by 12. 60 minus 64 is 4 divided by 12. This calculation, see minus sign, because 60 is smaller, you're getting a negative sign here. This standard normal changes to Z. 66 minus 64 is 2. 2 divided by 12, this is 0.17. You can just take 2 decimal point, because if you use a calculator, the decimal goes in recurrence. So just take 2 decimals. So then area, then this marking you are going to do it here in the normal curve. See, 0 value, 0.33, minus 33 is in the negative side and 0.017 is in the positive side. So x is lying between these two. This area you have to find out. This area you have to find out. This value you have to find from the table. So area from minus 0.33 to 0.17. How do we take this? How do we take it? We take it. Area from 0.33. Now 0.33 to infinity. See here. 0.33 to infinity minus this value. Minus area from 0.17 to infinity. So you have to see two times the table values, that is minus 0.33 to infinity you have to see one value, and then in positive page you have to see 0.17 to infinity. We will see that. So we will go to the normal distribution page, minus 0.33 we will find out. Where is the negative value? Yes, in the negative value. Please pay attention, minus 0.3. Coming to the third one, this is the first one is 0, 1, 2, 3 here. 0.6293, that is 0.6293. 0.62, here it is 0.6293. Similarly, again we will go to the page and we will find this area. Coming to the positive page of the normal table, we will find 0.17 to infinity. Yes, 0.17 positive, 0.17, yeah, here it is, 0.17, one seventh one here. This is the value, 0.4325. So So 0.6293 minus 0.4325, you simplify 0.1968. Students, first and foremost, I do not want any confusion from your side. If you pay attention, things are more simpler and more easier. You only have to pay attention. एक बार वीडियो देख के मेरे को समझ में नहीं आया, नहीं आएगा, नो नो नो, यू हैव टू सिट एटलीस्ट फॉर टू टाइम्स एंड सी इट क्लियरली. दे आर एक्सट्रीमली ईजी. यू आर ओनली गोइंग टू फाइंड दिस प्रोबेबिलिटी शेडेड एरिया फ्रॉम द टेबल, दिस पार्ट हियर यू गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट हियर, राइट देम, बिकॉज यू कैनॉट राइट देम इन द पॉइंट्स. यू गोइंग टू फाइंड द प्रोबेबिलिटी वैल्यूज हियर इन द नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. दे आर ऑल नथिंग बट द प्रोबेबिलिटी वैल्यूज हियर. दीज आर द मिडल, ऑल दे आर प्रोबेबिलिटी वैल्यूज एंड दीज आर द जी वैल्यूज हियर. So from that only you want to find out the probability values. Then and the third part, the third probability here is x less than 62. Same thing, you're going to write x value as it is, x minus 64 divided by 12. Then here 62 minus 64 divided by 12. This changes itself to z. This is smaller. Then you get the negative value, minus 0.17. Then you do that marking area on the normal curve. This is how you are going to do the marking. Negative values, Azma's Panchi 0.17 is going to be somewhere here. It is less than, this is the line what you have drawn here. This is the shading part, this side. So the area is going to be from minus infinity to 0.17. Your table value is of in the form z to infinity, not from infinity to z. See, your table is from z to infinity, z to minus infinity. Your table value is not from infinity to z or minus infinity to z. Remember this. But here in this particular example, what is here? Area is from minus infinity to minus 0.17. So we need to make an adjustment here. See, area from minus infinity to minus 0.17. You cannot calculate this. So what adjustment we have to make? We have to take area from minus infinity to infinity minus area from 0.17 to infinity. And what is that? See here. Area from minus infinity to plus infinity, you will subtract this much area. Ye pura area nikal dena hai. You have to remove this. So that is minus 0.17 to infinity. This is how it is written here. And area from minus infinity to plus infinity is 1. This total area is full 1. It is full 1. So that will be 1. And this from the table you are going to find out. That is your task. You are going to go to the negative page of the normal distribution, minus 0.1. Come to the 7th column. See that value. And it's going to be 1 minus 0.5675. And it will be 0.4325. Practice it, children. Very important. We will see the next example. One more example. Marks scored by the students of a class follow normal distribution with mean 80 and SD 5. Find the probability that a student selected at random from the class scored more than 90. Second point is between 70 and 85, and third is less than 75 marks. So in normal distribution, nothing will be equal to it. It will always be less than, more than, or in between. Always it is like that. So what is it? Marks scored by the students. So z is equal to, first step is to write the given things. Mu is how much? 80. Here in this example, sigma is directly given. It's not given in the form of variance. If it is given in the form of variance, you have to take it in the form of standard deviation. So our value z is equal to x minus 80 divided by 5 is a normal distribution with mean 0 and sigma 1. Now we are going to find out the first. What's the first one? Student scored more than 90 marks. More than means here already the shading is towards the right side. This is the central line here. If it's more than, towards that side. If it's less than, towards this side. So here again same step, x minus 80 divided by 5. And here this 90 minus 80 divided by 5, this changes to z, and this value 90 minus 80 is 10, 10 divided by 5 is 2. This you are going to mark here in the graph. This you are going to mark it in the graph. So See, again the normal curve minus infinity plus infinity zero value 1, 2, 3, 4, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. This mandatory, you have to draw this normal curve for each and every example. Fixed it is. Keep this in your mind. Where is 2? 2 is here. And what is this sign here? More than. So this is the area. Or from here, it can be the child can score. Actually, 90 comes here. This is your 90. Mu is nothing but your 90. There means the child can score more than 91. It can be 92. It can be 92.33, 99 point. The number can be anything. So the area is from 2 to infinity. This is the area. And here you have the z value. This is your z. The table is available to you all. So straight away go to the table from 2 to infinity. Well, I will show you all. 2 to infinity. Come to the table part. Positive value 2. Yes. 2, 0 column. 2, 0 column, 0.0228. This is the value. Yes. This is the value here. 0.0228. This is the probability value. Let us see the second probability. Students scored marks between 70 and 85. 70 and 85. So 70 and 85 means, see here, first one 70, we are writing 70 minus 80 divided by 5, then x in the form of standard normal variate, then 85 in this particular fashion. Simplify this, you get minus 2, this changes to z and this changes to 1. And in the normal curve here, this is the normal curve, minus 2 is marked here. Plus 1 is marked here. In between means, yes, the area between these two values. These two values. How do we write this area from minus 2 to 1? So this how we have to break up. Area from minus 2 to infinity. Minus 2 to infinity. Minus this area you have to do. Minus area from 1 to infinity. When you, from this total area, if you subtract this, you get your desired result. So go to the table, find this value, go to the table, find this value, and finally you get this answer. Similarly, the third part also is like that. Student scored less than 75 marks. That is, x is less than 75. X, again we are writing in this form, 75 value substituted, 75 minus 80 divided by 5. This changes itself to z. 75 minus 80 is minus 5. Minus 5 divided by 5 is minus 1. So here in the normal curve, minus means negative value, you mark it here, negative side. What is this here? Less than means the shading is going to be here. Your probability value is here completely. How do you write it? Area from minus infinity to, see, area from minus infinity to minus 1. You don't have the table from minus infinity to z. So you're going to change it. How do you write it? You take area from minus infinity to plus infinity minus this area. So this is the same thing here. Area from minus infinity to plus infinity minus area from minus 1 to infinity. Minus infinity to infinity is 1. Then from the table you have this value and you get this final answer. This is how you solve normal distribution examples. Very easy. Yes, it is easy. The only thing is you have to sit aram se and practice. Ek bar, do bar video dekhne se sar mein nahi jayega. Aur jab aap log video on karte ho, to dhyan se suno, dhyan se dekho aur solve karo. Apne aap aa jayega. So we have done with today's class. See you in the next class. Thank you so much.